Welcome, ambassadors. So today we are going to see how do you handle these types of functions. They are telling us that if f of x is x plus 3, find the value of a if f of 2 is 9. First of all, we first get rf of 2. Rf of 2 from here, this is my f of 2. And I put where this x I put 2 will be equal to 2 k into 2 plus 3, where there is x I'm putting 2, which will be 2k plus 3. So my f of 2 is this. Now they are telling me that my f of 2 is 9. So from here, my f of 2 is 9. First of all, my f of 2 is now 2k plus 3 equaling to now a 9. From here, I just put here. Now I take this inside and we have 2k equaling to 9 minus 3. So my 2k becomes a 6, and from here my k divided through by 2 becomes a 3. And from there, after doing the value of k, you come and write it back. From here, now my f of x is equal to my k, which is now 3 into x plus a 3. Now I come to this. I first get f of negative 3. My f of negative 3, I put here. B and B, x in 2, now where there is, I'm into bk in 2, where there is x, I put negative 3 in brackets plus a 3. When I multiply here, my f of negative 3 becomes negative 3k plus 3. By telling me that my f of negative 3 is equal to negative 15. So from here, now just we say negative 3k plus 3 is equal to f of negative 3 is equal to negative 15. And I write right terms. Now I take this side and here negative 3k equal to, and I take this side becomes minus negative 15 minus 3 becomes negative 18. From there, our k becomes, if we divide through by negative 3, this negative will go, your k becomes 6. Now my f of x is, from here, it was k, my k is 6, x plus 3, and that is the function. Now, from there, I'm going to use that idea in this number. So here, they are giving us that our h of x is equal to cx plus b. Now, they are giving us two conditions. Why? Because we have also two unknowns. So first of all, they are giving us that h of 1 is 9. So where I put, where there is x, I put in 1, the one will be 9. So meaning that my c in 2, where there is x, I put a 1 in brackets, plus b, the order will be 9. This will be c plus b equaling to 9 and then 5. Equation 1. Still, I come to this, that means that my h of negative 2 will be negative 3. So when I put where there is x, I put negative 2, I'll be having now my c in 2, now negative 2, then plus b, this will be negative 3. So this will be negative 2c plus b equaling to negative 3 as my equation 2. So we can solve these two with ease. So I bring equation 1 minus equation 2. When I bring them, I'll be having c plus b equaling to 9, my equation 1, then negative 2c plus b equaling to negative 3. I will subtract the 2. If I subtract this 2, c minus minus 2, I'll be getting negative 3c. B minus b, that is 0, equaling to 9, minus minus 3, that will be a 12. It will be 9 minus, then minus 3. This will be now plus, to give me a 12. And when divide through by 3, this becomes a 4. Now, because this is 4, when you come here and put 4, you can see that from my c plus b equaling to 9, if my c is 4, your D will be a 5. So rewriting this equation back, now my h of x becomes my c is 4, so 4x then plus my b is a 5. So if I substitute now, the one with less get h of 3. Before is write this equation after getting the unknowns. So now my h of 3 from here, hence fine h of 3. Is what I'm solving now to be 4 into 3 cross the brackets, then plus 5, which will be this is 4 plus 5, which is 17. So remember, that's how we have that number. Now you can try out this one yourself. I wish you the best.